Hi everyone, this is Propeller Boy. The first couple of videos of my gameplay of The Last Guardian have suffered some video corruption problems, so I might upload the Twitch streams, I don't know. But I think I have the problem sorted out. Ironically, it was from upgrading my video capture software. As soon as it reverted to an earlier version, I was just fine. So this is my continuing journey through The Last Guardian, and because this is the first one officially on my YouTube channel that I'm going to be posting, I think. Oh my goodness. And I've opened this with a huge fail. You know, I actually should have followed my instincts and continued to run away like that little trap at Inside. Anyway, I'm going to be presenting my thoughts on the game thus far as I go through it, which are mostly very positive. By and large, I think this game is an absolute masterpiece. And in the design and the philosophy and the aesthetic and everything, I have nothing but good things to say, except for the one issue, and that is the issue of control and camera. So I'll start with that. The control is a little goofy. I can sort of chalk that up to, you know, you're a boy who might not have the same agility, or although he's got a lot of upper body strength, that's for sure. Can I make it back up there? Oh no, what do I do? Come on down, Trico. Can you give me your tail or something? Help me back up? Nope, no dice. The camera control is like one of the worst I've ever seen. Certainly it's the worst I've ever seen for a game of this nature, where the camera is really integral to you know, what you need to. Where you going, buddy? What's up? There we go. There's where we need to go. The camera gets stuck all the time. Well, that's not what I needed to do, damn it. The camera gets stuck all the time. It's really not very responsive. It's not very good at lining itself up where you automatically where it should be. And frankly, I mean, if you take a look at one of the very first instances in which a camera ever had an impact on a 3D platformer, which was, well, I guess I couldn't have climbed back up anyway, which was Super Mario 64. I feel like Super Mario 64, head and shoulders for all of its camera problems, had a far better outlook on the way that the camera is run than this game does. Now that being said, can I make that jump from here? No, I can't. That being said, outside of the camera and the control, and that can be make for a very frustrating sort of thing, this game is absolutely astonishing. It's brilliant. It's heartfelt. It is a real refinement of the ideas behind Ico and Shadow of the Colossus. In fact, this game is sort of to a degree a reverse Ico in the sense that instead of being on an escort mission where you're escorting around this character who really can't do anything, as it turns out, oh, maybe I climb down here, I don't know. No, I don't climb down there. Trico is the one who has all the abilities. You just have to be able to coax him to get you from A to B. And that's really nifty. So we're going to try this again. Obviously, he has to go over there. Trico's design is absolutely brilliant. I mean, anyone who has ever had a pet, you know, cat, dog, bird will see elements of Trico in the design, elements of their pet and Trico's design. It's just, even to the fact where sometimes he can be stubborn and not do exactly what you want. I mean, he's an animal. And animals quite often are particularly... What you gonna do, bud? You gonna reach out? Are you gonna catch me? All right, I'm gonna try jumping. You better catch me. There we go. Good work. Leap of faith. Good boy. So the design is amazing. The AI I find is actually pretty good as well. Some people have complained about the AI. I don't think the AI is honestly a problem at all. This isn't a game that's meant to be beaten quickly. It's a game that's meant to be done at a leisurely pace. And it feels really, actually, it feels really very much of a different time than this. Like, games nowadays seem to be all about, like, instant gratification, instant, you know, and this is actually a very slow-paced game. And the interesting thing I find about the puzzles for this game is that they're very organic. A lot of them are environmental. Ooh, is that food? No, it's not food. A lot of them, it's not like they're immediately obvious or not obvious. There isn't like a glowing thing to like suggest to you this is what you need to do. It's just a matter of finding the right platform, finding the right hole. Occasionally there is visual aid. To let you know where to go. Oh, what's... That's gonna kill me, isn't it? Okay. Do it again. Oh. Oh, I see. Get nailed by the tail. Oh, very dramatic. Okay, you're okay, buddy. It's all right. Well, I've inadvertently started this chapter in a very dramatic fashion. Okay? Is that a... What's this? Can I do something here? There you go, bud. Hooray! Thanks for saving me. And there we are. Now, usually the moments in this game aren't quite so overtly cinematic or dramatic or those sorts of things, but, like, there's really a remarkable progression. It's okay. Remarkable progression of the bond that you have, and like the detail that they've put into Trico's face, his body, the feathers, the little gestures that he does, it's truly outstanding. Now here's an excellent example of the camera sucking. Really hard to get off. I can't even get off him, good gravy. Most of the times that I dismount off of Trico, I just fall on my face. That was a bit more successful. Maybe there's a technique that I'm not currently up to. But essentially the plot is you wake up and you find this beautiful, crazy, chained beast, and you feed him a little bit, and he comes to trust you, and then the two of you work together to get out of wherever you are. It's okay. And then you encounter these stone knights that Trico is able to fight for you. Here are a couple of them. They haven't activated yet, but here they are. Oh, there they go. Come on, buddy. Fight him for me. So in this case, you basically just get out of his way and let him take care of it. Trico still is bleeding from a spear wound that he had when he was chained up. What's going on here? What's with this, Kill him. Kill him, Trico. This is new, this little... Well, I guess this isn't gonna do it, so I'm gonna get off of you. And I'm gonna hope that they can, like... I don't know why this is keeping you at bay, buddy. And usually, you sort of have to fight the influence here. I don't know why Trico is a little freaked out. Let's see what... Can I climb this? No, I can't. Oh! Swing and a miss. Weird ass knight. Whoa, that's a pit. The game is very vigilant about not letting you fall down pits. Fearful of the symbol in the glass. Where's the symbol? He doesn't like those eyes. Thanks for the hint, older me. Oh, it's up there. Okay, I see. I did not look up. Can I climb up there? How do I get up there? Oh no. Okay, that's how you do it. Alright. Sure, I'll grip it. Grip it good. I don't know what I'm accomplishing. Climb it? So this is the sorts of the puzzles that you encounter all the time, and sometimes, like, they begin in a very straightforward fashion. Come on, let me jump. I'm jumping. There we go. There's a barrel for Trico to eat. Is that on a track? It is on a track, okay. Well, let's see if I can... See if I can pull it. But I am literally hitting the button to grip it. Oh, I gotta hold it. Okay, fine.
Atimeti Sizi, Akianeki, Yehuchi, Etizi, Atimeti Samazi, Oizi, Inuizi, Bonizi, Oye, yes, Awizi.
There we go. There you go, that should do it. Alright, go to work, Trico. Good boy. And then he just demolishes all of the guards. Hopefully that didn't break my legs. Nope, good. Quite often, if you take not enough fall damage to die, you never actually see yourself dying. But if you take enough fall damage to die, the game just sort of like you go, it fades to black, and then you start from the checkpoint basically. But with regards to the fall damage, you can actually take more fall damage, and then you sort of wander around with like broken legs, and you actually cry out for Trico if you summon him. It's okay, bud. So now he's done a... you call out for Trico and he gets agitated. He gets very agitated. No, I should have jumped from there. I tried to. It's okay, buddy. It's okay. Calm down. That's a buddy. There we go. And where's your food? Eat your food. Where'd your food go? And again, another elegant dismount. Where's your food? Oops. Did I miss it? Did I throw it somewhere weird? Did I throw it in a pit? Are you lying on it? It down, didn't I? Let me just go up and take a look. I don't know whether or not you even need to have all the food. Oh, that's where I threw it. Okay, fine. Eat the food, buddy. Nom nom nom. There you go. Damn it. Alright. So now that you're down here, friend, what are you thinking? How do you feel? Where are we headed? Do you have something in mind? It's funny, because sometimes he'll just take you, and sometimes he needs to be led. I guess in this case... No, no, what are you doing? What are you doing? What are you doing? There we go. Now the frame rate really stutters in some places here. I'm running a PS4 Slim. It's certainly strange to be seeing a game run at 30 frames per second. I am not used to that on current gen consoles. Or PC for that matter, of course. Don't break your legs. Good. Hey, buddy. What's wrong? I failed to see the problem. Are you pissed? You should be excited to be outside. You're normally so excited to be outside. Yeah, see? Look at that. Oh, you don't like that, though. Alright, fine. I know you're scared of that thing. Well, I definitely just went the long way around that staircase.
Diablo? Oh, magic.
So this is the latest series of obstacles, is that, clearly, ooh, do I have to Indiana Jones out to that thing, I wonder? Yeah, Trico, it's okay. I can't make that jump, can I? No. He might be able to lift me up, I suppose. How tall? Like right in front of, right in front of my head there is a ledge with a, I might be able to have one of these little, they're very claustrophobic little crawl holes that, oh, I'm back here, all right. Have I cleaned this place out? See, the thing is also the world is so expansive, it's hard to know whether or not, okay, came to there. Oh, do I have to go up there? You give me a hint, buddy? You're giving me a hint. All right, I'm coming. Oh, there's food, that's why, I see. You're jazzed about the food. Typical animal. So the evil eye is freaking you out. Yeah, I see it, camera. I see that there's an evil eye there. Boy, can I get up any higher? Yeah, but I don't see the purpose in that. See, this is the problem with the camera. Like, it doesn't really give you the view that you want to... Can I make that jump? That's important to know. Yes, I can. Can I make this one? Yes, I can. I don't know if I can make that one, though. I can make the jump to the chain. See, the camera's helpful in that regard. I keep forgetting that jump is triangle. It's not X. Team Ico games have this weird thing where they make... Jump is the, oh, I don't hang. Nope. Maybe I do want to hang. Okay. Hiya! Oh! Well, this is certainly the largest puzzle in terms of environmental scale that we've seen thus far. Nope. Such a graceful boy. I nearly hit the X button, too. Well, I don't think I can get back up there now, anyway. This studio excels in making these senses of, like, huge landscapes. Am I accomplishing anything by doing this? I don't even know. I can't even tell. So I'm able to get there. There's that. It's being held up by. Can I climb up it? don't know if I can. Maybe I can. I guess I can. Just climb up the broken glass a little bit. Oh. And go through the other side. Do I want to go through the other side, or do I just want to keep climbing up? I guess I want to go through the other side. Maybe I don't. Maybe that's where I should have gone in the first place. I climb through here. I go through here. I turn around. Whoa. I'm trying to get to that. That busted pane. Come on, I can clearly get to that. I've been there before. All right. Where is it taking me? To the bottom, okay. Yeah, I don't think I can actually climb that, can I? Let me onto this thing? No? No, it won't. Okay. So let's see. Whoa. Dangerous. Okay, so I can climb up to that. I can climb through. What do we have on the other side? Doesn't look like anything. Is this just a red herring? I don't even know. Maybe it really is to get to the... Come on, let me down. Let me down. Oh, no, I can do that. And that's a really wonderful camera angle, Sony. Thank you. Can I do anything? No. Climb to here. Climb up. I can do. Okay. So it's just a matter of patience. 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 Get past those shards. See, that's a really neat little environmental puzzle, right? How do I get to the top of this nonsense? Do I climb up on this? Don't know if I do. Oh! Well, we can try it. Let's see if I can release this. I don't know. Probably not. I have the feeling that I'm just gonna, like, let one of these things let her rip and then, Is there a release? Nope. Just a big old waste of time. Okay. Now can I swing this thing to like, is it a momentum puzzle? No, it doesn't seem that way. But this is the beauty of this world, is that like I genuinely, normally I would find these sorts of puzzles very frustrating, but I do not. Because they're designed in such a way that they're really okay. Control issues notwithstanding, they're really fulfilling. Don't put me at the bottom of that. Can the checkpoint please be like, okay, good. That's better than a kick to the face. Alright, so I just basically need to get from one to the other. I would like to climb. I would like to climb this, please. It is a chain. Thank you. Now, I do have to reiterate, the thing is, the control for this game and the camera, like, they are really not good. Like, I can understand it doesn't need to hold my hand. Oh, okay. I have the feeling that as soon as I launch this, though, it's gonna, like... No problem. Well, it's really... the way that he looks at you. Way to go, buddy. How you feeling? Now where should we be going? Are we going over there? Are we going this way? What are we doing? Are you just interested in this? I feel like we shouldn't be going that way. I feel like we should be going the other way. You ate your food, right? I feel like I've gotten all of the barrels so far. There you go. You can jump to that. Couple of jugs. Oops. Damn it. Whoa. There we go. Feel better? Why are you lonely? Oh God. You all right? You're okay, bud. You're good. Now, what's over there? That's interesting. Drawbridge. Precarious scaffolding. Turn us around, bud. Turn us around. Can you reach up? I need to get up there. Are you saying no dice? Let me go over there. Nope, no word. No way to do it. What you gonna try? You gonna try something? Down? What's down? Oh, okay, I see. I keep forgetting about your tail. One thing you should bear in mind when you're playing this game is that if the camera is being super obstinate and Trico is being super obstinate, you might think of going in the less obvious direction. You know, honest to God, this camera is so awful. Okay, hang out, Budsky. It's all right. But there's been other very organic puzzles. Trico with his tail stuck in the door, and you have to go around without him. You're trapped in a room with the knights, and you need to let him in order to get away from the knights because he can kill them, and you can't. Very cool stuff. Yeah, I'm over here, bud. It's all right. I swear it's...
Are you kidding? I can't believe that you save it.
Oh, that's so nice. Cute little cutscene. No. Not what I wanted to do. There we go. I do want to get to that precarious scaffolding, don't I? Alright. Into the murky depths I go. We got rocks. Okay. Now, I still have yet to figure out what these frigging blue doors are. I don't know how to open them. Maybe I just gotta run by him?
Look.
You're kidding me. You're kidding. That's absolutely brutal. Swing and a miss, Knight. I don't know what's there. Ooh. Oh. There we go. I guess I probably can't push them down or anything. Just stay. I'm gonna try going upstairs. There's another frigging blue door. Very good. Where'd the knight go? Oh man. Precarious scaffolding. All right, of course. Really? Boy, this is tense. Yikes. Okay, hang on for a few, bud. I'll figure it out. Help. The infamous crotch cam. Spikes and crap at the top, alright, fine. I just want to go onto here, okay. Very good. Can I grab anything here? There's a ladder? Where to? I'm going as fast as I can, my friend. There we go. Here we go. Success. Anything in here? Just scenery? No food? Well, this is interesting. I mean, like, can I actually pull that myself? What's wrong? Why are you scared? Are you hungry? Is that your tum tum? Akuna tisodu, atana kam, agikuna inaik, atrikono. Yeah, that's his tum tum. Amazing. I don't think I've ever heard a stomach growl before. Well, at least I can maybe get a better view. Oh. Look at that. Throw down some barrels. Anywhere else where that chain could have led? Just not immediately obvious, like, what's a foothold or something like this. It's funny, because one of the gripes that I often have in these sorts of games is that it becomes too obvious. Like in the Uncharted series, you see some conveniently shaped, highlighted rocks. Now this, I feel, might have gone a little bit too far the other way. So I've climbed up here. Can I, like, scale something to get to the other side? Can I, like, drop? This doesn't look particularly inviting. Dude, I know. Hi, Trico. I can see you. Whoa. Well, that probably broke my leg. Yeah, so now if I call to him, it's even pained. Okay, so I think the point of this puzzle is that I need Trico to get well enough to be able to pull this thing out and let us through. So I need to have him eat. Okay, let's try this again. Oh, so I can get on this thing. Is that a climb ledge? No. I mean, this doesn't seem very friendly. Oh, there's a grate. I just feel like there's nowhere else for me to go right here. Can't get high enough. Can't make that jump. Can I get up on that angled piece of wood? Seems like I can't. You gonna help me out, buddy? You're just gonna sit there. Oh, I'm broken my leg again. I know you're hungry, boy. I know you're hungry. Well, let's see. I just have no concept of what that chain is supposed to do. No, you're too hungry? Won't do anything? He has some spears in you? Dude. Alright, fine. The greatest camera, greatest of all camera angles. Alright, what else do we have over here? We have ladder chunk. Can't get up any higher than that. Just how to get over there. Okay, I'll try the left side. I feel like it's like a little ledge. Oh, and I broke my leg. All right, folks, I think I'm going to call it a day for now. But that is a rather dramatic chunk of The Last Guardian. Hope this has recorded properly. We'll see in a little bit, and I'll upload it to YouTube, and keep continuing installments of this really magnificent and unique game. Thanks a lot.
Hey, Boomer Buddies, give me a hug.